Are you guys ready for your headliner? Woo! For Micah Smith, everybody!
Man, don't let the skin colors fool you. I'm the most awkward black man y'all have ever seen. Be in the mirror practicing for everything. Dance moves, conversations, you know, all that. My name is Mike Smith. Kev, what's your last name?
Oh, it's Patzo.
All right, that don't sound that hard to pronounce, right? Fuck up, Michael. Substitute teachers love to fuck that shit up. Did anybody else have that experience?
No.
Michael.
You tell them your name and they just automatic. Michael? Micah. Where the fuck did you hear an E at? Like, where are you going with this? And random people on the street love me. Hey, big fella. That's not your introduction card to come talk to me. I'm 6'5", I don't mean, hey. I like conversation. Come here, bud. No, I'm still black. I don't mix well. As y'all can see, when I stepped up, I'm a big dude. And that scare a lot of people, so I try to diffuse situations with my voice. You know, I ain't come up here very white. You know, because myself, see, I'm the black man. You know, big guys, we get a lot of smoke, all the time. Because like, if I walked up to you in the middle of the street, you don't have to be nervous right now. I saw the fear. Yeah. I heard your butt won't get tight. If you saw me, you wouldn't walk up and try to start a conversation.
No.
Keep it pushing. Exactly. That's what I want everybody in this fucking world to do. Stop. Don't patronize me just because I'm big and black. He must have a story. He's got to have a story. It's tough times. I bet he grew up in a ghetto. So yeah, but I did. Stereotype ring true today. I really don't care about the text, but that has nothing to do with this next joke. Yeah, man, as a big guy, I sweat too much. Too much. Yeah. I was at my boy crib at a family gathering, everybody standing in the kitchen. I'm looking around like, where are y'all sweat beads at? It is 80 degrees in here, and everybody just talking like it's cool, drinking water. I'm here about to pass out. It's my fault. I wear sweatshirts with no shirts. That's just me though. Yeah, man. I like fucking with girls who got father issues. Wait for it. When they call me daddy, it's authentic. They never knew what that was. No, but I'm saying that like I'm a magnet. I'm at like 3 girlfriends. Hey, yeah. And then those 3. They was cool, they was smooth, they moved my ego. They all look better than me, but you ain't got nothing much to do that at all. But I waited for them to call themselves ugly. I turned into August out of season. You right, you is looking pretty stiff over there. My time for me to upgrade. I hate that shit. You keep calling yourself ugly. Now, I might start believing you. I might get my confidence up. Lord knows I get on Tinder. How you doing? I'm on Snapchat. I'm Snapchat famous, you know. A lot of my friends here only came because I'm funny on Snapchat. I wanted to try this out just to see if y'all laugh and it worked. So it's cool. I just turned 20 today, so that's cool. I needed that empty applause. Thank you. Yeah, I like to tell stories on Snapchat, give other people a reason to live because my life is shit. My dad's an asshole. Definition of asshole, Eric Smith. Well, I'll tell y'all a story real quick. I used to play football when I was younger. Who would have guessed it? Played Little League, so nice little rivalry game. Games happen, I go to make a tackle, I break my wrist. I immediately look for support in my father. What is he doing? Drinking a beer, hopping over a fence. Mike, what the hell are you doing, man? Get your pussy ass up and get back in that game. What he didn't know at the time is I had a severely fractured wrist. All he thought was I wanted to get out of the game because I'm fat and lazy, which is true, but not the reason. I ended up blocking the rest of that game with one hand, going out to eat because nobody gave a fuck about it. Dude, I'm telling everybody my wrist is broke. Shut the fuck up, Mike. What the hell are you talking about? Wrist broke. He think he a doctor in this motherfucker, don't you? It took one of my mom's coworkers to look at my wrist throbbing insanely. I'm like, Callie, you need to take this boy to the doctor. She's grimacing at her. Deals, bitch, deals. I show up to my dad's house with a cast on. Well, shit, guess it was broke. What kind of father? Guess it was broke. It's a fucking cast on my hand. I told you at the fucking game. That's about me and my dad don't talk today. My body's not about completely other reasons. I took my Skittles. I really like Skittles. Taste the rainbow, no homo. All of that. I didn't get this confidence for nothing, man. You know, it took a lot of hard work and dedication in my mom's beard. Skittles, you know, man. Dance moves, I'm really rocking on any rock. I'm sorry, y'all don't know what that means. These guys. conversation, like I said, I'm the most awkward black man. If I see a random black man in the street, I'm gonna act like Justin. I'm good. No, because we had that unspoken thing that you're supposed to speak when you make eye contact. Some people do it, some people don't. I used to work in a hospital. I like to say hello to all the females, diffuse the situation. No, they look at me like I'm fresh off a rape case. Girl, did you see how tall he was? He got three bodies in his trunk right now. Hey man, but y'all been great. I really appreciate this, man. My name is Micah Smith, young black and purple.
I'm really rocking any block, coach.